Hello, today I'm going to show you the steps that I go through when assembling an electric EEW wheel. Now a few of these parts have a little bit of work done on them already. I'll show you what goes into putting together an electric EEW wheel. That'll also be useful if you have to repair it. So the first thing I do is I take off these labels from the laser cut pieces. So these pieces are the pulley that goes on the motor. These pieces that I'm undoing right now are for the dial to control the tension. Oh, I actually am missing a piece for the dial. Let me grab that. Right over there. Here we go. This is the last piece for the dial. And this is sort of the main case. This goes over the circuit board, and these pieces will be used with the flyer as the pulley. Okay, so once I've got these, I take a piece of sandpaper and I just take off the roughness. Both sides. It's a pretty quick process. I did that one. But you don't actually need to sand all the pieces because some of them aren't accessible or aren't something you're going to touch very often. So, like these pulleys, these go inside the dial. These two bigger ones need to be sanded because you can get to those. And that's it for sanding. One other thing I'll show with the sort of prep work section is I get this long tube here that's I use for the feet, and I have a little mark on this 2x4 for the right length, which I think is a half an inch. And I use this. I found this razor blade makes better cuts than using something like a scissor. So I'm going to make the four little feet here. And we're done with these pieces then. Okay, so next up, I'm going to start parts that need to get glued together. So, we're missing some more pieces. Oops, sorry about that. So, yeah, these are going to be the front and back, obviously. And I'll get the sandpaper back and we'll just sand these a little bit. There. Okay, so now we are going to start assembling the pieces. Then I found a trick is I usually use a rubber band, or I've got a bunch of these extra belts that are the wrong size, so use those to sort of hold this thing together and make sure it looks right. Then I've got some glue here that I found works pretty good, and we glue the seams. I'll also put these little feet on at this point. While I'm gluing, I tend to like to assemble all the pieces that need glue, so the pulley on the motor gets glued in. Oops, there are some magnets. Let's see. Also, this piece will be glued in. So this is the tension dial, and I found it works a little nicer if I glue together the wooden pieces. and one other piece that gets glued in are these. So it's important to get these in the right spots. This one goes on the larger one here goes on the front. Just put a few drops of this and you'll also notice, actually maybe it's easier to put it in here, you'll notice this one's got different front and back, so I always put the concave portion facing inward. Okay, so now I can let that dry. We'll start assembling the flyer. So two of these circles are the same size, and the one that's a little bit smaller goes in the middle. And these bolts here hold align things. And now I'll, whoops. Now I'll install these flyers. So oops, did I get the wrong one? Oh, some of these are wrong. Yeah, some of these are prototype pieces. Whoops, let me go get the right parts. Okay, we're back. Now we've got the right parts here. So the other ones didn't have the right plastic part, and it made them slip a little too much. So I usually rub these. The first one I put on, I go back and forth a bunch, and that'll make it slide easier. There's these little notches in them. And the second one, I don't move around much because that one's going to stay fixed. So this one moves easy, and this one's sort of locked into place. And I do the same thing here, but it's important to make sure you get mirrored images for these, so I'm making sure that happens. Again, this first one, I move it back and forth a few times, and the second one, just put it on. Whoops, there we go. And then I make sure that it's going to, the hooks are going to be pointed in the right direction. I did exactly what I said not to do. So I put these on backwards. No big deal. You need flip these then. There. Then and of course my battery's dead. Let me go get a new one. Okay, we're back. So we will finish this. I just kind of get them started. And there's a few more pieces. Push through, get these guys started. Get these a little snug, you know, pretty snug, not too tight. And then get these lined up the way I want them and finish tightening them. Okay, and that's the flyer. It's now assembled. So at this point, I'll do a small amount of soldering that needs done. So both the motor and this dial needs a little soldering. A little flux, it makes the solder go on a little easier for this part. And go like that. And then, so that part's put together. And then we've got the motor, and there's a red dot, and I want to line up the red dot with the red wire. Make sure the motor turns in the right direction. And that should be it for soldering. I did realize I forgot to glue in one part. So these magnets here, these are tiny little magnets. So we just put a drop of glue. And there you can see I kind of had a little extra glue, but a nice solution for that. Just sand off that extra glue. There we go. Then might as well make the hook here. So I just bend over the end of a wire. This is the hook. Actually, because the glue's not dry, I won't attach that yet. So next I'm going to go back to where I was, and this is shrink tubing. So I have a heat gun that shrinks this. I'm going to step away and go do that. Okay, I accidentally killed the audio for the rest of the video here. So I'm just dubbing over the video. The audio now is actually done after the filming, because I lost the video when transferring it from the camera to my PC. Anyways, now at this point I am screwing the motor wires into the circuit board, and the circuit board has a little writing on it, and one of the holes says black and one of them says red, so you can definitely screw the red wire into the red one, obviously, and the black one into the black one. But you can actually switch those, and nothing will get damaged or anything. The motor will just spin in reverse. So now I've got a 2x1 inch piece of foam that I'm going to lay down on the bamboo. It's sticky on the back, so it sticks in place. And this is one of the things I did to reduce the vibrations of the motor and help reduce the overall noise of the electric eel wheel. So then to hold the motor in place, again, sort of this new motor mount on this version of the electric eel wheel, is that I'm using O-rings. They're, you know, sizable ones, and they actually work really good to hold the motor in place. And I've got those needle nose pliers to help me sort of pull it through onto the other side. So we use two of those to hold the motor in place. Thinking back, it might have been a little easier to actually attach the wires to the motor controller at this point, but you know, this is obviously one of the first electric eel wheels I assembled. I'm sure that the process for assembling them will improve after we've done a few. So at this point, I'm taking some of the screws and putting them through the wooden case, and then I've got these little nylon spacers that go under the PCB to sort of keep it off the bamboo, and then after the little spacers are on, I put the screw through the actual circuit board. And then once I've got those screws through, I put the large spacers on, which is followed by this wooden piece, which sort of protects the circuit board. Yeah, I had a little trouble here because the screws weren't all the way inserted, and I wasn't sure what was going on. But then I've got these lock nuts that I screw on just a little bit by hand, just getting them started here. And after that, I screw them in until they're, you know, snug. They don't need to be really snug. Basically, the threads just need to be all the way through through the nut to make sure they don't vibrate off. But they are a lock nut, so as long as the threads are through, you should be good.
So now the glue's been dry for a while, so I removed that band that was holding it together. And the next thing I install is this little potentiometer. This is what controls the speed and direction. So there's a little notch on the potentiometer, and there's a little rectangle cut out of the case, and basically you align those, they fall into place, and then I put a washer on, and then there's the nut. And you know, this is another one of those parts where you don't need it to be super tight, you just want to get it sort of on there nice and snug. Just snugging things up with the pliers. Then I put the little plastic dial on. It's got a little screw in it to attach it to the potentiometer. And I plug the wiring harness from the potentiometer into the circuit board. If you get this reversed, the wheel will just go in the opposite direction and you can flip it. But once you've assembled a bunch of them, you'll get a feel for, or you'll know how to plug it in the right way, so things go in the right direction. So the power supply I'm using, I was trying to figure out what was going on here. It was kind of behaving weirdly. The problem was that the cord that goes from the wall into the power supply was not fully plugged in. I'm going to fix that a little bit later. But right here, I'm just, you know, going forward, not thinking too much about what's going on. And at this point, the motor's actually turning. You can't hear it. But, you know, I'm just testing it to make sure the motor turns in both directions. And it does. Spins in the correct direction. So now that I know everything's working, I take the flyer and whoops. Well, I guess I set the flyer back there. Now I'm going to attach the Scotch tension cable. So there's actually holes in both sides, so you can put this on either the right side or the left side. The right side is the side I ship it with. But if somebody's left-handed and they really want it on the left side, it's easy thing to switch over to the left side. You just need to take out a bolt and untie a knot and then sort of switch it. But I tie it onto the dial there. Now I'm just grabbing a pair of scissors. I'm going to trim off the extra so it doesn't get sort of caught in there. That looks good. Now I thread it through that little hole. Trim that off. And now that's ready to be attached. So there's just a, this is another one of the lock nuts. This one has a little flange on it to help it twist. So I, because it is a lock nut, it's easier if you put a little wrench on the back of it. And then because the nut or the bolt is actually glued into that dial, I don't need to use a screwdriver. I can just sort of twist that dial. You just need to make sure that the elastic band doesn't get sort of stuck in there when you get it tight. And this is something where you want to kind of get it snug, because you don't want it to turn too freely or it won't hold the Scotch tension. But if it's too hard to turn, then you know, that's no good either. It'll be too hard to adjust the scotch tension. So you get it sort of a medium tightness there. So now I'm putting the orifice hook onto the magnets. Oh, at this point, I actually realized I put the I had the that base piece. It's on backwards, so the magnets should actually be on the other side. They'll be on the other side in the version I ship out to most people. But yeah, I mean, it doesn't really matter which side the orifice hook is on, but just for consistency purposes, I'm gonna try to get it onto the right side on all the wheels. Now I'm putting the flyer on. But before you can do that, you gotta put the drive band onto the motor pulley, basically. When you're installing the motor pulley, you wanna sort of check to make sure that it's in line with the bigger pulley. Like, it's pretty easy to get it a little out of line, and the band sometimes pops off, so you want to make sure that's in line. And I'm putting the nut on the back for the foot pedal, adjusting the scotch tension, and now it's fully assembled. The only thing left to do is test it. So we just plug the power cable in and make sure one last time it spins in the right direction. So actually, as you spin the wheel more, the flyer fits into those braces perfectly, and you'll notice the volume of the wheel actually reduces over time. But to sort of speed that process along a little bit, we just touch each side a little bit with sandpaper there to quiet it down a little bit. But that's pretty much all there is to it. So thanks for watching. Bye.